An air turbine power plant with two stages of compression and two stages of expansion has an overall pressure ratio of 9. The air enters each stage of the compression at 280 Kelvin and each stage of the turbine at 1200 Kelvin. What is the power output of the turbines if the mass flow rate of air is 150 kg per second? As always, pause here and try solving this problem yourself before watching the solution. This is the first example for the Regeneration, Intercooling, and Reheating main lecture, and it uses concepts from the Brayton Cycle main lecture too, so make sure you've studied those two lectures before attempting to solve this problem. The links to those 13 and 11 minute lectures respectively, and all the other lectures of the Thermo course are found in the description below. We know that the power that the turbines output is equal to the mass flow rate times the specific work of each turbine. If we draw a quick TS diagram for this Brayton cycle, we see that the specific work that the turbines output is equal to the change in specific enthalpy values, H5 minus H6 and H7 minus H8. Since we're told that the air enters each turbine at the same temperature, which we stated in the main lecture video as common practice for reheating processes, then H5 is equal to H7 and H6 is equal to H8. This means that the specific work is just 2 times H5 minus H6. Therefore, we need H5 and H6. H5 we can find right away because we have the temperature at the entrance of the turbine. As for H6, we know that we can find it if we have a property that defines state 6. If we had a gas here that has a constant specific heat as opposed to a function of temperature, we could use the relationship we derived in the reference entropy 12-minute lecture called approximate analysis, link below if you haven't watched that yet. This would allow us to find T6. However, since what we have here is air, which we do have tables for because the specific heat is not constant for all temperature values, we can use the method we labeled exact analysis. The ratio between pressures is the same as the ratio between relative pressures. We solve for PR6 to define state 6, and with it, find the specific enthalpy value we're looking for. We see that we need PR5, which we can easily find in the table for the given T5 temperature. Now, for the ratio P6 over P5, we know that P4 over P1, or P5 over P8, is 9, given by the problem. Since P5 over P8 can be written as P5 over P6 times P6 over P8, and P6 is equal to P7, we see that P5 over P8 is equal to P5 over P6 times P7 over P8. And since the jump from 5 to 6 is the same as the jump from 7 to 8, then P5 over P6 is equal to P7 over P8, which means that we can substitute P7 over P8 by a P5 over P6 to state that P5 over P8 is P5 over P6 squared. This just means that P5 over P6 is the square root of P5 over P8, the square root of 9, or just 3. And since we want P6 over P5, we take the reciprocal to say it's 1/3. We substitute these two values to find PR6, and with the table, we interpolate between its closest two values from PR to H to find H6. Check the interpolation lecture and examples linked below if you don't remember how to interpolate. We substitute H6 and H5 to find the specific work of the turbines, and we multiply by the given mass flow rate to find their total power output. Notice that when interpolating, we could also find the temperature at the exit of the turbines. It's not asked in this problem, but it will help us define the cycle better. If you want to check out other examples with regeneration and intercooling, make sure to check out the links I left down in the description below. You'll also find the links to the other lectures of the Thermo course, as well as other engineering courses playlists. Thanks for watching!